Hello and welcome to another edition of Friday Night Football. I'm here in the beautiful city of Chelsea. It's also Friday Night Bands, so don't touch that dial. We're going to see a halftime show. I was going to practice pole vaulting, but I let it go. They didn't have the mats. I'm going to get a closer look here. This is a beautiful facility. I pushed this sled around a little bit. And then back to the action. Dexter is in the white uniforms. They are in Division II, and they're one of the top-ranked teams. And they do the hurry-up offense, so you got to be quick with these guys. There's not much time to stand around and rest. Was waved out of bounds, so 3rd and 17. Off the fingertips. 4th and 17, and they're going for it.
And then pass complete to Jake Jimmack at the 19-yard line, knocked out by Ethan Fallon, short of the first down.
Well, nice catch, but the Chelsea Bulldogs will take over on downs. There's a couple of Bulldogs there, but they have a nice, wow, that was a throwdown. Penalty flag. They'll march this one off. I think they call that the horse collar or personal foul.
Leading out of bounds, defense number 7. Each one carries a 15-yard penalty and at the end of the play. Two personal.
That was like a double whammy. I think that was a 30-yard penalty. A 15-yarder and another 15. I've never really seen them add those up like that. The band is getting ready for the halftime show, so they're not leaving the building. Here's a field goal attempt. It's up, and it's good.
With 5 minutes, 19 seconds remaining in the first half, Dexter 21, Chelsea 6.
The ensuing kickoff. Going to have to switch tapes here shortly. There'll be a little intermission, so if you want to get a popcorn or if you want to get a beverage out of the beer, see what I did there? A beer out of the fridge. But the Dreadnoughts, that's their nickname, the Dexter Dreadnoughts. I was going to Google it or Wikipedia it. It looks like it might be some kind of battleship from back in the day. But it's not like you would think. I first thought the black folk like to wear their hair in dreads, I think is how they put it. But different thing, totally different thing. Okay, that was the end of the tape. All right, so... And it's the Chelsea Bulldogs. That's a more common nickname, but I like those unique names anyways. That's cool. All right. Yeah, this was week number 9 in, okay, second tape's in, press play. And All right. Yeah, and there's this mysterious powder that the Dexter students section was like throwing up in the air. It smelled like a little bit like baby powder. All right, speakers. They have a good sound system here. So we're going to catch the band here shortly. And Chelsea, they're in Division 4. I got my little cheat sheet over here. Division, fumbled it just before the goal line. What are they going to do?
The Browns pass complete to Nathan Gershew.
It'll be Dexter ball, first and goal at the one.
It'll be like first and goal around the one, so... He fumbled forward, but they give them that. There's different rules for high school, college, and pros. That running back zero did pretty good all night long. Someone told me Dexter had 5 Division I prospects for their football players. So, it's up. And it's good.
28, Chelsea 6.
So 28-6, Dexter is pulling away a little bit here. Yeah, the Bulldogs are a smaller school. They have, according to the enrollment guide, they have 778 students. 778. Dexter, in Division 2, has 1,107. Okay, so a bigger school to be sure, but these Dexter and Chelsea are like two cities that are almost, you know, they're rivals to be sure. So there's probably no love lost between these schools, although both cities are pretty hip. Earlier, if you watch Motor Capital, I was able to take a little tour in downtown Chelsea. All right, the band has some heavy artillery, so they're moving that into place. Meanwhile, there'll be a dance team and different age brackets. So they start them out young, and they'll do a little cheer routine, and then we'll get into the band. So I'm just going to take a little break here for a spell. Back in the day, I could do a somersault. Now I'm not so sure. This is a Division IV marching band. It's about the same size school as Dearborn Divine Child, which also has a great band program. So their marching band is top-notch, but watch these guys here, too. Very admirable job.
This evening, we are proud to honor our senior band members with a performance curated and designed by them. Featuring selections from their 4 years of CHS, band members of the class of 2025 are excited to share with you the song.
Yes.
At this time, we would like to recognize our senior band time at Chelsea High School. From percussion, color guard, and band camps in the middle of summer, to parades, football games, winter concerts, solo and ensemble festival, pep bands, and... Next, we have Haley Weatherholt, accompanied by Michael and Holly Marinuk and Christian Manos Weatherholt. Next, we have Sophia Safian, accompanied by Amanda, Arthur, and Delilah Safian. Next, we have Owen Vanston Alford, accompanied by Jim and Andrea Alford. David Leschuk, accompanied by Daniel and Stephanie Leschuk. Cameron. Tune has captured the hearts of many listeners across the globe. Originally performed by the British American band Katrina and the Waves. Chelsea High School Bulldog Marching Band. The leaders of the Bulldog Band are senior Jordan Nelson and juniors Rory Welling and Everett Critchfield. The color guard captains are Emma Woodard and Caitlin Lambert. Percussion instructor is Joseph Berry. Our color guard instructor is Amanda Bowser. Associate director of middle school bands is Miss Katie Stecklack, and director of high school bands is Mrs. Allison Roberts. Once again, your 2024 Chelsea High School Bulldog Marching Band. Thank you, seniors.
Yeah, I'd like to say it's more than just a football game. There's layers of everything when you come to a game here. Just the crowd atmosphere is really kind of neat. It's a family atmosphere too. I like this grassy area in the end zone. Because that's a big play area for the kids. Not a lot of stadiums have this. In fact, very few, but it's like a magnet for the young kids to play, and then the adults can watch along on the concourse and see all the action. This would be a good layout for a soccer stadium. They want to build one in Corktown for the Rouge, La Rouge, the Detroit City Football Club. 17,000 seats or whatever, but they could have an open end zone like this where young families can let their kids frolic and burn off some energy, and then you could still see the football game or the soccer game, whatever you prefer to call it. Traditionalists have it their way kind of thing, but yeah, this is a nice atmosphere out here. Chelsea does it right. Reminds me a lot of Allen Park in the way they do football, too. So they got all their bases covered. Well, came out here a few years back, and it was playoff season, and there was a nice snow, and the kids couldn't help themselves. They were just, like, tobogganing down the hill. It was just, you know, you live vicariously. I remember back in the day, years ago, I would be up to that when I was a young whippersnapper. That would be fun, sliding down a hill. We'd go to Ford Field quite a bit. The family would take us. We'd go tobogganing and sledding also. All right, well, the third quarter here, and I was wondering if Chelsea would make a comeback. But Dexter is a juggernaut, I think is the way they kind of put it. They probably will do some damage in the playoffs. They're punishing the balloons here for some reason. But, yeah, well, they weren't happy that Chelsea wasn't doing a little better. But Chelsea, they're going to 7-1. They were into this, and they might have a nice little run in the playoffs. They have a lot of football tradition here. I think I showed the banner with all their playoff runs and titles and all number of things. Here's the referees. There's a penalty. This is going to be kind of like a football overload type show, starting here with the Friday night football. Then I'll get to some college action. As luck would have it, the Spartans were visiting and going to Ann Arbor to play the Wolverines, so that was a big to-do. And then the Lions had a home game against Tennessee. So if you stick around that long, we'll get all levels of football here. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And yeah, people might say football overload. No. It's like cowbell. You can never have enough cowbell, right? Same thing with football. This is the turf they have here. Like sleight of hand. But yeah, they had no huddle offense. They moved quick.
Go.
Oh, kids nowadays, where do they find the energy? All right, well, this is the fourth quarter, so we flip-flopped playing field position here. But Dexter's trying to score yet again. It's up, and it's no good. Off the goalpost. All right, there's the Chelsea Bulldog there. Yeah, I had a little bit of a drive to get home, so I left a little early, but that's the way it was around 9 p.m. And so look at, Friday Night Football. They were under the lights. What a great scene. And then it's Halloween season, so there were a lot of scary decorations all over the place. All right, I found my vehicle. When you press the key thing, it lights up the lights. And so, yeah, this is the right one. I was monitoring the baseball, too. Proud to be American, which is cool. So I-94 back home. And there's the muffler man. They had the selection Sunday on Sunday, 4:30 p.m. on a channel I don't get anymore. It used to be Bally's, now it's the FanDuel Sports Network. And for a premium, you can get all that. But Marty the Bear was keeping watch on the porch. I hear there's a lot of porch pirates out there, so that's Marty takes care of that problem pretty good. All right, so this was game one, and you can only show little bits and pieces here, but I'll just show you kind of like the score. So New York was up 2-1, and now it's tied. Yikes. Top of the ninth. And there were a couple people on, but, yeah, you watch on your cell phone, and there's like a 20-30 second delay or something. I didn't time it out exactly, but you get the action before the TV does it. You know, a lot of times people on TV just don't use the proper language. So if they have to bleep something out, you know, like a 30-second delay or whatnot. But, yeah, the Yankees 3-2 in the top of the 10th. In extra innings, they don't put the guy on second base to start it. It's the real overtime kind of thing. But anyways, yeah, the Yankees, this was an exciting game. The World Series is living up to the hype. So, and then that was a crazy play. There was all sorts of stuff. And then this. Oh, wow. A grand salami. Wowee. Walk off homer. All right. So Dexter Chelsea, the game ended up 35-6. So Dexter, this Howell and Belleville, what a game this must have been. Channel 4 was out there. Howell won by a point, 30-29. Fortson came up in second place or tied for second. Here's an update after week number 9, which is the end of the regular season. Advanced Tech Academy won again. They have a good record. Etzel Ford took it on the chin, as did Annapolis, although they scored some points, which is good. Crestwood lost in a fairly tight battle there. Robichaud lost. Divine Child won. Fortson lost probably to a tough Northville squad. So, okay, after the regular season, this is just arbitrary. This is just the Dearborn and Dearborn Heights schools. So Advanced Tech Academy and Divine Child in these standings would have been tied for first place. And then Dearborn, Fordson, and Crestwood, they were at 5-4. They're bubble teams. I didn't know what the Selection Sunday came up with. Anyways, this Saturday was a big to-do because the in-state rivalry, the Spartans versus the Wolverines. So, yes, it was scary indeed. Just like this Project 2025, that is freaking scary. Do we want to lose our democracy? Some people think this is all a joke. No, this is for real what these Republicans want to do. Those who stay will be champions. So you probably recognize this guy with the glasses. And yeah, they won the championship for the 2023 season, even though I think both bowl games were in January, the month of January. So earlier this year. All right, White Claw. They were doing a little advertising up in the sky. Look at some of the brickwork here. And they were doing some tailgating back here. Oh, we're going to watch some band action. This is worthy. They have the drum thing before the game and before their march. Let's listen in. Thank you. Oh, for heaven's sakes, be careful. Get to watch the marching band make their approach to the stadium. So it happens like an hour to an hour and 15 minutes or so before game time. Game time was 7:30. Tracks. Slow's Barbecue was out here. Yeah, a lot of tailgating action going down. I'm anxiously anticipating the start of this parade. I'm kind of a big band groupie. Here's Hoover and Green, appropriately named for the cross streets where it's located. But yeah, down yonder you see the big block M. Yeah, that's where the stadium is, the big house. All right, looks like we're underway. They have their motorcade with cops on bicycles and motorcycles. And oh, yeah, you can see them. It's a pretty big band, too. I think it's over 400 strong. I didn't count them all, but so I'm told. So that's an unofficial type thing. Don't hold me to it.
Thank you.
There were a few bottlenecks to work through here, but I'm trying to keep up with the band, kind of hop, skip, and jump in front of them a little bit. But a lot of other people had the same idea. They gotta work their way right through the heart of the tailgating section. So a lot of people have their buffets going and all that. It's kind of a pinch point. But yeah, they make their path though. They work their way through, they're on a mission.
Thank you.
Okay, they have to go through the Lloyd Carr Tunnel to enter the field. So there's a process to do that all too. Last but not the least here are now going to enter the field. Yeah, game time 7:30. We gotta sing the national anthem. There's the seal of the state of Michigan.
Footballs, frisbees, and beach balls. Seat cushions containing any type of metal for those.
And you can get here by bus. Here's a party bus too. Big time. They had a good tailgating spot right in front of Chrysler Arena. There's another big block M. There was a little crunch at the entrance point. So get there early and often so you can avoid the lines. They're up in the top row. That looks like some, maybe some Navy people. Here's the national champions. So they say 2023 national champions, even though it was the college football playoff in 2024. It's expanded this year to 12 teams now, so that'll be exciting. The throng still making their way inside. This is on the southwest entrance. There's a new, relatively new coffee place here. You can get pastry and toast. Ooh, there's Sparty, complete with attitude. Wow. And then we got some good arch design here. The stadium itself is kind of an engineering marvel. I like the idea that you enter like the concourse and then you go like, you know, you can go, what, 20, 30, 40 rows down? And then you can go, like, 40 rows up? I'm not exactly sure, but they made it kind of like a bowl-type thing. And what is it, around 115,000 if they go with the standing room now? All right, so Main Street and Potter, they have these nice big scoreboards, and they had a tribute here for the national championship. Let's listen in.
Proud member of the Big Ten Conference in pursuit of championship football.
So I didn't have a ticket to the game. I don't have that kind of money. But there was still a lot of tailgating action going on the outside. And if you didn't want to walk, you could take one of these things. They're kind of quite colorful. Electric assist on those bicycles. But yeah, it was game on. And the game was on the Big Ten Network. So it's dropped down a couple of notches when it used to be on national TV kind of thing. But, both teams were 4-3. That's kind of like an insult, but I'm not sure. Yeah, that was mean. But, 7-Eleven. The Yard, that might be an outfit that makes these complexes and has some fun with it. I think they might be a chain a little bit. Here's some home prices in Ann Arbor. Ann Arbor always makes like the top 10 list of coolest places to live in the nation. And with good reason. They have a lot of things going on for them. So when you're into the urban planning aspect, it's good to actually look at Ann Arbor kind of is a role model of what a city is doing right. It certainly helps that U of M has a major presence in the city. That keeps the city young and full of vitality. Not to mention these kids are smart young whippersnappers. So they have a lot of art. Like, art is everywhere. So this is colorful. This is on the backside of the building. They have an Irish bar, but that guy was guarding the entrance, the back entrance, that no one could go in, so they probably were checking ID. Here, vote. So if you're a cat person, certainly vote. Yeah, I voted already. I didn't vote for the dictator. I want America to celebrate its 250th birthday party as a democracy. Oh my gosh, Trump already has bought and sold the Supreme Court. They'll basically give him carte blanche that he can do anything now. And it would be just scary if he gets back into office again. This isn't like big time wrestling or the unreality of The Apprentice and all that. This is our democracy at stake here. Why people are willing. We had 4 years of the Trump nonsense, the three-ring circus. We don't need another 4 years. This show is for mature audiences only, but they have a famous painting back here celebrating the beauty of the female art form. You are here in the Motor Capital. Although this is my local yokel show, I'm doing the local yokel in the city of Ann Arbor. A touchdown, so Michigan is now on the board. So, pending the outcome of the extra point attempt. And, did they miss it? Yeah, they missed it. And then they got a field goal before the half. So they got alleys in Ann Arbor, and they got artwork through here, too. Yeah, vote. Definitely vote. This is the AB alley. Oh, I went overtime. I do that sometimes. It's a 1 hour show, and I'm 1 hour and 1 minute. Yikes. So anyways, nobody gets this far in the program anyways, but if you did, thanks for watching. Hope you have a great week or weekend, whatever the case may be. Good night. I'm going to shut this down, and it'll appear on Motor Capital Extra, the continuation of this.